Hello everyone, I am Raman Pahuja. Thanks for opening this video and keep watching till the end, because in this I'm going to explain you about Kanban and pull system. So in this we'll learn about basics of Kanban, types of production systems and objective of pull system, and types of old Kanban and their usage. So let's start with the Kanban. Actually, some people says that Kanban is nothing, it's just a card which is not so important for us, and some people says like Kanban is a pull system, but not exactly. Kanban is a very important tool of lean manufacturing system, and who said like Kanban is a pull system? It's not true. Kanban is not a pull system, it is just a tool of a pull system, okay? So which was developed by Taichi Ono at Toyota. So before going further about the Kanban, firstly I will tell you about the types of production system, because to learn about the pull system, firstly we have to understand the other production systems also. So the first one is make to stock production, second is make to order production, and our third one is pull system. What is make to stock production? Actually, in this we produce the part in advance and build a stock, and when the customer will demand for the parts, then we will dispatch to them. So it is totally depend upon our prospect. So when our prospect will be wrong, then it will happen for short shipment or excess of stock. Okay, for example, we just produce the 1000 parts of any product, okay, based upon our prospect that customer will take next month 1000 pieces, but in actually they demand only 100 pieces or 200 pieces, then there will be excess of stock for us. So make to stock production is not reliable for us. And the second one is make to order production. So in make to order production is like when customer will demand for the products, then we will produce the parts, then we will start production. So in this the lead time for the customer will be high. Third one is pull system. In this there will be no short shipment or excess of stock, because in this we will have a store in which we keep the safety stock of every parts. Okay, so when the customer will demand from us, then we will dispatch the parts from the store, and if the demand will be high, then the safety stock will be reduced from our store, then we will inform to production that to produce that parts, and if the demand will be low, then we will inform to production that don't produce that parts, because in this month the sales result is very low. Okay, what is the objective of pull system? As we already know, like it supports the lean production system and it is based upon our sales result, but the main objective of pull system is lower inventory and reduce the lead time. Okay, so now I will tell you about all types of Kanban. So mainly we have categorized two types of Kanban, movable and storage. But in movable there is four Kanban, like customer withdrawal Kanban, supplier withdrawal Kanban, in-house withdrawal Kanban, and production Kanban, and fifth one is storage Kanban. Now the customer withdrawal Kanban, as I already told you, the Kanban is a tool of pull system. So if the customer will require the product, if they will send the Kanban to us, so it means they are pulling us for the parts, then we will send the parts to the external customer. Same as supplier withdraw Kanban, if we need the parts, then we will pull our supplier through the Kanban, then the supplier will deliver the parts to our raw material store. And the third one is in-house withdraw Kanban. In-house means if production unit required the raw material from our raw material store, then the production unit will pull the internal raw material store through the in-house withdrawal Kanban. Then our raw material store will deliver the parts to production unit. And the fourth one is production Kanban. If planning team will require the parts, then they will pull the production unit for the production, then the production unit will produce the part and deliver to the planning team. So the production Kanban will tell us like what to make, where to make, and how much quantity we need to make, and when we need to make the parts. The fifth one is storage Kanban. So in storage Kanban, we will use only for store the material. If we need to store the material, then we will use the storage Kanban. But remember the rules of Kanban. The quantity in the box and quantity on the Kanban should be same, and it will be attached only with the good parts, not for the NG parts. So now it is the overall flow of all types of Kanban. For example, the customer will require the parts, then they will pull the plant FG store, and plant FG store will deliver the part to customer, and then plant FG store require the parts, then they will send the parts Kanban to planning team, and then planning team will send the Kanban to production unit. So it means they are just pulling one by one according to their requirement. If customer require the part, then they will pull the plant FG store, then plant FG store will pull the planning team, planning team will pull the production unit, production unit will pull the internal raw material store, and they will pull the external supplier. That's why the Kanban is used as a tool of a pull system, because through the Kanban we are just pulling them for the material, and they will they are delivering the parts to the according to their requirement. Okay, and if we need to keep the WIP, then we will use the storage Kanban, and then when required for production, then we will send to the production unit. So this is the overall flow of all types of Kanban, and that's why we call this as a pull system. So thanks a lot, and if this video is useful for you, then please like and share this video and subscribe that channel to get more videos, because my forthcoming videos will be basics of capacity, capacity planning and industrial revolutions. So if you have any query regarding this or any topic, then you can contact me via WhatsApp or by my email ID. So thanks a lot for watching.